I'm Jake,
and that's Kevin.
Today is May 23rd, 2014, and here's the school year's final Hicksville News broadcast.
Today's lunch, we'll be having school pizza. Peaches, snap peas, tossed salad, pudding, and you can't forget the milk.
Later in the news, today's top story will be providing useful tips for exam taking. This should help your stress levels go down and your grades go up.
But first, many of you are boring people over the summer and you don't have plans. And if that's you, here are some of the top 10 places for you to visit of the summer 2014.
Coming in for number 10, Dallas, Texas.
Yeah!
Number 9, Anaheim, Santa Ana, California. Righteous.
Number 8, San Francisco. Stay away from Alcatraz. You know what I mean.
Number 7, stay classy, San Diego.
Number 6, Atlanta, Georgia. Good old Atlanta.
Number 5, Washington, D.C.
Number 4, Long Beach, California. Cowabunga, dudes!
Number 3, New York City. Let's go see a Broadway show.
Number 2, Orlando, Florida. Surf's up, man!
And landing strongly with number 1, Chicago, Illinois, home of Bears.
Doubles.
Duck-ups.
Hi, I'm Kyle.
And I'm Micah, and we're here with your community news.
This summer, the pool will open on May 31st. The hours are from noon to 6. Single passes will cost $30, and a family pass will only cost $60.
For any questions about the pool, call 419-542-8541. Also, the playing fields will be open from May to September. For any questions about that, you can call 419-542-6589. There is also plenty of other fun things to do this summer.
Salads. I mean, what is he, a herbivore?
Whatever.
I think he's like, what are we forgetting here?
My water bottle or something. Maybe all these Happy Meal boxes.
Maybe.
Well, hey, Eric, I think they put the camera on here, didn't they? Look at this. Give me a smile. Give me a smile. Oh, yeah.
Did they leave that on?
Yeah, it's really on.
You want to, like, mess with it? Might as well.
I think I do.
Yeah.
Well, I think I do.
When they come back, they'll totally be like, what?
Yep.
Did they, like, leave something on there? And then we're going to be like, no doy.
Yep. Okay.
So you're, I'm Pat Ron Burgundy.
Pat Ron.
Pat Ron.
Okay. I'm,
Davis.
I'm Crispy. Crispy McChicken, or is it not downright?
Wow, it's not professional as well.
I'm Robert the Donald. I don't know if that makes sense, but hey, see, they got a little scoop here.
Pat Winslow, reporting live from Fox News.
Ronald Dosslin, here.
Tonight's top story. Go ahead and tell him, Pat. Go ahead, Pat.
It's Ronald.
Ronald.
Looks like we have the
what?
Double the
board on us. What are we gonna like do also?
Well,
we're gonna screw around your house and chair, but like swim in.
Well, first of all, Danny's out.
But yeah, we're gonna go to your house and chair, work on the old Mr. Dirty Duramax.
Nope.
Okay.
Just partying. It's a chicken wings.
Oh yeah!
Bonfires! Swimming!
Yeah, you know what else happens during summer, I'm sure?
What?
Like, you know. All them like...
Oh! The STDs of summer, as they say.
You know, like... STDs?
Of
It's not what you think,
but it could be.
Hello, I'm Amy Sweet, and today I will be talking about the STDs of summer. Swimming, tanning, and driving. All of these things may seem safe, however, they all have the potential to be hazardous when done without the proper safety precaution. Swimming statistics. From 2005 to 2009, there were an average of 3,533 fatal unintentional drownings in the U.S. a year. That is about 10 deaths per day. Also, about 1 in 5 people who die from drowning are children 14 and younger. Luckily, there are many ways to stay safe when swimming. 1. Swim with a buddy. 2. If in a pool setting, follow the pool rules. They are there for a reason. 3. Never eat or chew when swimming. You could choke. Next up is tanning statistics. In the United States, indoor tanning is estimated to cause about 419,000 cases of skin cancer every year. For comparison, smoking is thought to cause about 226,000 cases of lung cancer every year. According to the 2011 Youth Risk Behavior Surveillance System, the following proportions of youth report indoor tanning is 13% of all high school students, 21% of high school girls, 32% of girls in the 12th grade, and 29% of white high school girls. However, there are some safer methods of tanning. 1. Tanning outside. 2. When doing this, make sure you wear tanning lotion with SPF. And finally, driving. A total of 3,023 teenagers ages 13 to 19 died in a motorcycle vehicle crash in 2011. An estimated 1.2 million crashes each year involve drivers using cell phones for conversations. At least 100,000 additional crashes can be related to drivers who are texting. Staying safe while driving can be pretty self-explanatory. Always stay alert. Avoid distractions, even from passengers, at all costs. And do not use your cell phone while driving. Don't be another statistic.
Okay, Pat. I don't like Pat. Can we change it?
Sure.
All right, Harry. Hey, remember that one time we had a problem?
Yeah, because we like wore tuxes and they got dresses and we're like, let's go dance to the music until it can't stop.
But it did stop.
Right.
11 o'clock.
11 o'clock.
Should be 12. I don't know.
Then we went to Crazy Pins and we bowled. We go bowling, right?
I like to bowl.
We go bowling every Saturday night. Me, Cole, Jaren, Danny, Morgan, Katie, Bailey, Kate, whole gang. At the alley.
We like to bowl!
$2 bowling.
You should do it. Okay, well, let's finish this off for these. Finish it off. Now, since we were talking about all these things that happened this year,
might as well go to the highlights.
Take a look at this year's highlights, correct?
Like,
Harry,
you know, sports and.
Okay.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone. I'm gonna make this place your home. Fire up the ground and get the rocket shots. Yeah, you can be the greatest, you can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk the guy, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock. You can move a mountain, you can break rock.
Get on this paper, Pat. Pat, this is so stupid.
What?
Go ahead. Okay. Now for a fine and dandy commercial about the summer reading program. If you're into that kind of thing, I guess.
At the JML, Johnson Memorial Library.
The JML, I swear. If it,
like JFK, except it has an M and an L.
Yeah, if they called it JML, I'm pretty sure a lot of people would like.
Yeah, they got Mario Kart tournaments or involved.
Really?
Toy.
Are you a child looking for something educational and fun to do during the month of May? Johnson Memorial Library is the place to go. It is located in Hicksville on 116 West High Street. The library has many fun activities the rest of this month for children of all ages. Today, they will be hosting a Star Wars Day for fellow Star Wars fans to take part in games, crafts, music, activities, and more starting at 4:30. The library will be closed on Monday, May 26th in honor of Memorial Day. On Wednesday, the 28th, At 4:30, the library will be celebrating the end of the school year with an end of school year party. They will be having games, activities, food, and much more. On Saturday, May 31st, at 10:30, the library will be hosting a Mario Kart tournament on the Nintendo Wii. This month, racers will be going up against the best drivers that the Sherwood Branch Library has to offer. Snacks will be provided. During the month of June, they will be having a summer reading program for any students that are interested in having a fun experience for their love of reading. If you have any more questions, you can call the Johnson Memorial Library with this number on the screen. Hello, I'm Amy, and I'm here with Zachary Bowling from the Johnson Memorial Library talking about the summer reading program. So, Zachary, what is the summer reading program or challenge about?
The summer reading challenge is basically just how it sounds. It's a challenge to get students reading throughout the summer. You know, you guys put in so much effort throughout the school year developing these critical and analytical thinking skills. We just want to help you to retain that throughout the summer. So we're asking students to read. We have programs and events scheduled throughout the whole summer, and we have a lot of prizes and incentives to get kids out of here.
So what is the theme this year for the middle school and high school?
The theme for your guys' group is Spark a Reaction, and the younger kids is Fizz Boom Read. So you can probably tell we're doing a lot with science throughout the summer.
Neat. So how do you register?
Registration has been made really easy over the past couple of years. You can either stop in the library and one of the staff members will help you out, or you can go to our website, defiancelibrary.org. There's a link. It takes about 2 or 3 minutes to fill.
So what are the rules for the Summer Reading Challenge?
We've also really simplified the rules. Before, you had to read 20 minutes a day for 6 weeks. Now we're just asking you to read 6 books. On your grade level, of course. We've had students try to read board books and easy readers and pass those off as books. We won't take that. But if you can read 6 books on your limit or reading level, that basically completes the prize. And once you do that, we have a little sheet, about half a sheet thick or long, just asking some questions about what the book was about, stuff like that, to prove that you actually read it. But other than that, that's it.
Sweet. So do the students who complete the program, do they receive prizes?
Yes. Even if you don't complete the program, we'll have prizes throughout the summer. But some of our grand prizes right now, we have 4 free Kings Island tickets. We have Cleveland Indians tickets. Tons of businesses at Fort Wayne and Hicksville have given us free food, coupons, crazy pins, and putt-putt golfing game in Fort Wayne. Just a few. And then we're getting monetary donations as well. So hoping to maybe buy a laptop or something else to give away big at the end.
Well, that sounds like a lot of fun. Well, thank you, Mr. Bowling, for answering all of our questions.
Thank you guys for coming out here.
Hello, folks. It's Lucas Brown here with your Memorial Day weekend weather. And it's going to be sunny. 75 degrees and sunny. Beautiful weather. Great for going swimming or watching a parade on Monday. But overall this summer, just to do a last final weather newscast, it's going to be great weather the entire time.
Today's top story is exams.
As many of you know, if you have a 90% or higher in a class for the semester, you can exempt the exam if the teacher lets you.
But in case you do have to take your exam, here are some creative ways to study. Savvy study tip number 1, reward yourself. Savvy study tip number 2, type up your notes. You have a computer for a reason. Savvy study tip number 3, take breaks every once in a while. Savvy study tip number 4, laugh a little. Savvy study tip number 5, to see the grade is to get the grade. If you see yourself getting an A, you'll get an A, you know, probably. Savvy study tip number 6, eat healthy and get a good night's sleep. It may sound cliche, but it works.
So, Eric, you suck, dude. Now we made that music video. You know,
the music video.
Yeah. Can you see them put that? Wouldn't that be fine that I put that in there? Like in the newscast, like the way this goes.
Yeah, too bad they don't accept us for talent.
They accept the kind.
Yep. You hear that, Jake and
Yoli and Luke Brown and Kevin Troyer.
Yeah.
Mario, you're not.
Why?
You're not.
What are you doing?
Whoa. What are you guys doing?
Immaturity of some people.
It's ungodly.
So, since we were so rudely interrupted, I guess that's it for us in the junior year of 2014.
301 Dalmatians.
I guess we'll see you later, and have a nice summer, Hicksville.
Waking up every day right about noon.
Yeah!
My mama's screaming and yelling.
Get out of bed!
Don't worry, I'm gonna be up soon.
Now I'm finally out of bed
and ready to start the day.
Slip on my shoes, pants,
shirt,
and hat.
Feed the dog and maybe feed the cat.
Meow!
Now you're asking yourself,
hey, what should I do?
Stay at my house or call up my crew.
Hanging with your friends makes you feel stupendous. And since it's during summer, all the choices are endless.
Throw on a tank and hit the gym.
Or you can put on the cadence and then take a swim.
Everybody smile!
It's summer and there's no need to frown. Grab your boards, grab your blades, and let's hit the town.
It's summer, let's forget about the spring.
The winter.
And fall.
Get dressed.
Grab your friends.
And hit the Glenbrook Mall.
Have a barbecue with a couple of buds. Hop in the Duramax and stir up some mud.
Grab your clubs and let's hit the green.
Go to B-Dubs and suck on some wings.
Now the night isn't coming.
Let's call up the town.
Turn up the beat. And throw it down. 12 o'clock on the dot.
Maybe bedtime for you.
But for us, we're up to the cock-a-doodle-doo.
Some may say it's time to hit the hay.
Last thing to do is wait the summer. The summer's coming quick.
And you gotta have a blast.
You only live once, so better make it last.
So thank your teachers for all the joy it brought us.
But summer is here, and we'll see you in August.